Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics, and today we will see the difference between the ideal and the practical voltage source. So if you see any ideal voltage source, the voltage across its two terminals remains the same. So no matter what amount of current that you draw through this voltage source, the voltage across its two terminals will remain the constant. So if you see the VI characteristic, then the voltage across its two terminals will remain the constant irrespective of the current that is drawn through this voltage source. So the current that is drawn through this voltage source depend upon the load resistance. So the current I that is drawn through this voltage source can be given as Vs upon RL, where RL is the load resistance. So as the value of this load resistance decreases, the current that is drawn through this voltage source will increase. So in the ideal voltage source, there is no limit on the amount of current that can be drawn through the source. But if you see any practical voltage source, the amount of current that can be drawn through the source is limited. So if you see any practical voltage source which are available in the market, they used to define a current rating for the voltage source. So the maximum current that can be drawn through that voltage source depend upon the current rating. Apart from that, if you see practical voltage source, it has a series internal resistance. So the voltage that is appearing across its two terminal can be given as Vs minus I into Rs, where Vs is the supply voltage, Rs is the series internal resistance, and the current I is the current which is drawn through this voltage source. So as the current I which is drawn through this supply increases, the voltage drop across this series resistance will increase, and because of that, the amount of voltage that appears across this terminal will reduce. So if we see the VI characteristic, as the current that is drawn through this voltage source I increases, the amount of voltage that appears across these two terminal AB will reduce. So to reduce the drop across this series resistance RS, the value of the series resistance should be as low as possible. So in the practical voltage sources, the value of this series resistance is in the range of few ohms to the tens of ohms. So now let us see through one example that how the value of this series resistance affect the output load voltage. So here we have a two voltage sources which supplies the same voltage. The two voltage sources have a different series internal resistance, and the load that is connected across this voltage source is in a such a way that the current that is drawn through this both the voltage source is same. So if we see the first voltage source, the current I that is drawn through this voltage source can be given as V upon R, where V is 30 volt and R is 980 plus 20 ohm. So the current I that is drawn through this voltage source is 0.03 ampere. Likewise, in the second voltage source, the current I that is drawn through this voltage source can be given as V upon R, that is 30 divided by 100 plus 900 ohm. So the current I comes out to be a 0.03 ampere. So in the both the voltage sources, the current that is drawn through the voltage source is equal. So now let's find out the voltage that appears across this load resistance. So let's say the voltage that appears across this load resistance is VAB, which is given as Vs minus I into Rs, that is 30 minus 0.03 into 20 ohm. So the value of this VAB comes out to be a 29.4 volt. Now in the second voltage source, the voltage that appears across the load can be given as VAB, that is Vs minus I into Rs, that is equal to 30 minus 0.03 into 100 ohm. So the value of this VAB comes out to be a 27 volt. So as we can see here, as the value of this series internal resistance increases, the drop across that series resistance increases, and hence the voltage that appears across the load will reduce. So to get a maximum amount of voltage across the load, the value of the series internal resistance should be as low as possible. So now let's summarize the difference between the ideal and the practical voltage source. So in the ideal voltage source, it do not possesses any series internal resistance, or we can say that it has a zero series internal resistance. While in the practical source, it do have some series internal resistance. So in the ideal voltage source, the voltage that appears across its terminal remains the constant. While in case of a practical voltage source, the voltage that appears across its terminal depends upon the current that is drawn through the voltage source. So as the current that is drawn through the voltage source increases, the voltage that appears across its terminal reduces. So the ideal voltage source can supply any amount of current to the given load. While in case of a practical voltage source, it can supply a limited amount of current to the given load. So I hope you understood the differences between the ideal and the practical voltage source. So if you have any question or suggestions, please let me know in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.